Hi everyone, welcome to Naresh Technologies. This is Srinivas. In this session, we are going to discuss about how to create components, component objects in a Swing applications. First of all, here it is, what is a component? Components in Swing applications. Swing applications. The component means what? It's a class. Component is a class. The instantiation of class is representing that component. See, Swing components, examples of a Swing components, like we can say buttons, checkboxes, text fields, labels, all these are comes under components. See, by using components only, we can design our graphical user interface window, GUI window. So then how can we create? Suppose if you want to create a button, just instantiation of a button class is automatically will give one button to you. So where all these components are available? In the Java extended package, sub package is a Swing, and here is contains all the component classes. So actually java.awt package also providing components we were used in applets, components providing, but these components are platform dependent components. Sir, what is that platform dependency? And if component is a platform dependent, what will happen if component is a platform dependent component? Means whenever you are executing the application, Java application means what? You can run on any platform. But component creation logic is based on native code. What is that native code? Current operating system code. For example, if you are using Windows operating system, so currently Windows operating system, for example, developed by using .NET consider. Whenever you are creating that component, button component, right, Java button is means what? Creation is depends on the .NET logic. Suppose if you are using Linux operating system, suppose Linux developed by using C language, Java component creation logic is based on that C code, C language code. For example, if it is a Mac operating system, that is Objective-C code. So from platform to platform, the visibility of button or the visibility of component will change, and Java language application code is internally using another language code. To avoid all these disadvantages, they introduced the concept of Java X.Swing package component classes. And these components, what are these? Java X.Swing components are purely platform independent. Purely platform independent components. Purely platform independent components. And here platform independent means what? All these components creation logic is depends on a Java only, pure. So means what? They implemented the code using Java language only, Java syntax only. So that's why no need to depends on anything. So using Swings, we can develop pure Java standalone applications using Swing components and all. So how to create the component? So we'll see one program. For example, here it is a buttons one class we are taking. This is user class only. And it is extending the functionality of a JFrame class. And in the last session we discussed that JFrame class is available in a Java X.swing package. So JFrame. And next one here, I want to create object for buttons, and in the process of construction we will set up that complete window and all. So finally I want to make it visible by using set visible, and here it is, we are setting the size also. Here it is, this dot set size, some window size we are giving, like a 600 and 500 we are giving, 500, and something like this dot set title also I want to set, like buttons frame is the title, like this we are giving. Now I want to create a button. See here, where is the button class? I am creating one button class. It's just a variable initially. Either you can declare static variable, non-static variable, local is your wish. So initially we start with a static. Class name is a JButton class. Any object name you can give, it's something like B I have given. See, class variable means what? Always object. So this is the class, and this variable is a object. And JButton class is also available in a Swing package. So we have to import Java X.swing.JButton class. JButton means Java button. And here we are creating object new JButton, and the reference we are assigning to B, either by using a class name or directly, no problem, because with the same name local variable is not there. So whether you follow the rules or not is your wish. So here B equals to new button, but in the process of construction we need to specify the name. Just any name we are giving, click me is a button name I have given. See, whenever we are executing this one, it is showing that frame. Here just buttons frame name it is showing, but button it is not showing anywhere. Button it is not showing on the frame. Reason, whenever we are creating the button will be created separately, as well as the frame will be created separately. So we have to add that button component, we are adding to the frame. So here to this frame we are adding the button. What is it? Button B is the button. And now suppose if you execute this application, now look at this button added, but look at this button occupied the complete window size, width and height it is using. Button width and button height is also same. This is a button. Sir, I want to arrange at a particular location. There's actually one concept is there. The concept is called layout manager. Layout manager. So what is the layout first? Arrangement of components on the window. So to design the window. Manually you can design your own layout, or we can go with the predefined layouts also. So many predefined layouts are there. Predefined layouts. For example, flow layout is there. One example. Flow layout is See here it is using flow layout. Just we have to create object for this flow layout and we have to pass to the frame. How? See to this frame, to this means what? To the current frame we need to set layout, predefined layout only. Initially I want to set, what is that layout? Set layout function is there. See, by calling that set layout function or method, by calling this one, we have to pass flow layout object as an argument. Directly flow layout object we are passing, that's it. Now here whenever we compile, it is giving that error, sir, where is the flow layout class? So as of now, that flow layout class is available in the old package only. Java.awt is providing, AWT is providing that flow layout class. Flow layout, just compile this, no compile time error, and run this. Now observe here in this frame, look at that click me button. Here it is a top centered. Automatically this click me button is a top centered. This is the one. Sir, I want to arrange to the left side or I want to arrange to the right side. In flow layout only, in flow layout class, some static fields are there, left or right, like this. Suppose right I am giving, now automatically that will arrange to that right side. This is arranged to right side, like this it will arrange. This is in the same way, in place of right if you use a left, we can arrange. Sir, I don't want to use a predefined layouts. I want to set my own bounds at a particular location. I want to set. See, in that situation I need to specify I am using null layout. If you want to set your own bounds to the component, to the button here in this program, first we have to specify that it's a null. Then to this button, we have to set bounds. One method is there, set bounds method. Total four arguments we have to pass. What is the x coordinate value? What is the y coordinate? At intersection point of xy, the button creation will start. And next one, what is the width of the button? And next one, what is the height of the button? Total four arguments you have to pass. So first argument, x coordinate, for example, I am giving 200. Y coordinate also I am giving 200 at that intersection point. Button width also I am giving 200, and height I am giving simply just like 60. I have given 60. This is, now just compile it and run it. Now look at this, this is the button. X coordinate is 200, y coordinate is 200, width of the button, is a 200, height of the button is a 60. These are the components. So we can arrange and we can change the colors of the button and we can change the text font, text characteristics, everything we can change. And see, whenever you click on this button, it is not giving any information. That is actually what we called event listener's concept. So what is an event listener? And whenever you click on a button or whenever you perform any action on the component, how the component will react to your means what action and all the things that we'll see in the coming session. Hope you understood. For more videos, please subscribe to Naresh IT channel. Thank you.